At the center of it all is you that I see. Is you that I see. At the center of it all. At the center of it all is you that I see. Is you that I see. There is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift our voice in prayer. It's you that I see. It's you that I see. At the center of it all, at the center of it all, is you that I see, is you that I see. At the center of it all, at the center of it all, is you that I see. Is you that I see. Miracles happen in your name. There is power in your name. As we lift our voice in praise. Is you that I see. Is you that I see. At the center of it all, at the center of it all, is you that I see, is you that I see. At the center of it all, at the center of it all, is you that I see, is you that I see. There is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift our voice to say, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. Malagazunde brogozia ligazando. Legede brada bakada bradozia. Ligazunde progozi de brunda bakaza da brindea. Elegede do do rabasu da le progozi. Elegezunde progozia ligazida. Elegedu da brando. Elegedu zinde progozia ligazinda. Logodora kada baligo zinde brodia. Elegedunda braka da brando zinde progozi de brundia ligazuda. Elegedunda braka da baligazunde brozi. Legazuda, legazende, lagada ragada ragada branda, lototo ragada bracuzinde brocuzia. Father, I said I worship and adore you. Father, be thou exalted. You are the omnipotent, the omniscient God, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Father, I say be thou exalted, be thou magnified. I worship you because I know you will never fail. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. Beloved, this evening I'll be talking on a message which is titled, The Faith That Works. I'll be talking on a message which is titled, The Faith That Works. Let me tell you something. In life, before you can be able to overcome the circumstances of life, before you can be able to overcome the battles of life, before you can be able to overcome the problem of life, let me tell you something. You need to overcome, you need to have the faith in you. Faith matters a lot. There are a lot of people that have been passing through trials. The only way for you to come out is when your faith is at work. The faith that work. Show me a man without faith, I will show you a man that does not have work. Show me a man with faith and I will tell you his work. Malagazunde Brogozi Kalabrandaya. Let me tell you something. A lot of people in certain families, they have been passing through one circumstances or the other. Some people, when they get married, having children is a problem. Until you have that faith in you that with God all things are possible. Until you have that belief in you that with God you are coming out from that circumstances. Until you develop that appetite to say, Lord, only you alone is the hope of glory. You are the only man that can break me out from this course. You are the only man that can break me out from this problem. Let me tell you something, so nothing will change your faith. Hallelujah. At this hour, I want us to open our Bible, turn our Bible to the book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. La gazunde brogozia li gazada brada bakaza daya. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. I want us to see what the Bible says there. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. The Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good report. Faith is a substance obtained hope for, evidence obtained not seen. Malagazu de brokozia. Faith. Now, faith is defined as the evidence of you that whenever you pray, you have that belief, you have that faith, you have that courage in you that with God, that even though this thing I am praying for, this particular blessing I am asking God for, even though I have not seen it coming, even though I have not seen it manifesting now, even though I have not seen it now, but I still believe that it's going to manifest. That is faith. Anybody that tells you that they have faith when they pray and they believe that what they are praying for, they are going to receive it, even though they have not seen it, that is faith. The Bible says faith is a substance obtained hope for. A lot of us here, we have gone for commission. Though you have not seen the result, but you believe that the result is coming out to be positive, that is faith. And the faith that works. Your mother, your father might have entered into marriage, having children in different places, because you have that faith that work, that in my time I will not go through that circumstances. The faith will work for you, the belief. What have you been praying for many years? What have you been asking God for years? That you have not yet seen it manifest. You still believe, that is faith. Put your faith to work. The problem we are having in these days is that most of us do not even believe that when we pray, God can give us results. We are looking for prophet pastors to lay hand on us before we can believe that the miracle will come. No. Even though you don't believe, even when you don't have that faith, even when you don't have that faith, when the pastor pray for you, it's not going to work. Let me tell you something. If you study your Bible carefully in the book of Matthew, in the book of 1 Samuel, from verse 1 Samuel chapter 1, from verse 1, you will discover that the Bible says Anna always depend on the priest because he believed the priest has anointing. For Anna to pray, Anna will always go to her room to begin to sleep. For Anna to pray, Anna will always go to her room to cry. The time for prayer, she will be crying. The time to pray, she will be crying. She was doing her crying while the pastor was praying, but still yet there was no result. The very moment Anna woke up, the very moment Anna decided to say, it is not time, palabro kozinda brakadia. Anna allows and say, this year is my year. When I come to Shiloh, this nonsense must stop. This nonsense must, when I come to the presence of God, I am going to tell God my pain, how I felt it. It is not time for the priest not to pray. Let me pray. Until she developed that faith that when she prayed, God can answer. That was when there was result. When you enter into a relationship, that relationship do not work. When you enter, what you need to understand, the reason why a lot of us, we are still here, we are not yet married, is because some of us do not even believe. All the belief we have is all men are not good. All men are the same. You are making a negative decree in your life. Why can't you put your faith to work? The problem a lot of us we are still having in our time today is more of us, for us to pray and believe, we complain. We complain. You have to put your faith to work. It is not time for us to arise that this storm in my life must come to an end. This battle in my life must come to an end. Let me tell you something. 2020 was a year where many people struggled. 2020 was a year where many people was out of it. But let me tell you, this year 2021 is a year where God is going to visit a lot of us. But there are trials that will come. When the Holy Ghost opened my eyes to see, this year 2021 is going to be a year of favor, but there are trials that will come. You have to stand your ground and believe in God. Faith, the only thing we need is faith, the faith that works. Even though when others is going to question, even when others are looking for job, they are rejected, you still go to that same place and you believe that as I enter here, I will be favored. You still have that faith and confidence in you that as I enter here, I will be blessed. That is faith that works. Put your faith to work. Stop doubting your prayers. Put your prayers to begin to pray. Believe that when you pray, there is an evidence. Stop looking for pastors and prophets that will begin to lay hand on you. When you pray, there will be blessings that will manifest in your life. Pray with your mouth. A lot of us, we have given our bondings to pastors. Even pastors does not even have time to even study their own Bible. Even pastors does not even have time to even pray for themselves. Even pastors does not even have time for them to even say, let me take care. No, all they do pray. Let me tell you something. Do you know that when you put your faith to work, every mountain will be moved? Let's turn our Bible. I want us to see something in the book of Matthew chapter 8. Turn your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 8. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 9. Turn your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 9 from verse 20. I want us to turn our Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 9 from verse 20. Turn your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 9 from verse 20. We are going to be reading the name of Jesus. And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. 21, for she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. 22, and Jesus turned him about. And when he saw her, she said, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. Praise God. Now, when you look at this scripture very well, it is very sweet for us to memorize. It is very easy for us to say it. But there is something I want us to see here. Now, there is a mystery I want to unfold in this scripture. The Bible says, and she said to herself, if only I can touch. Let me tell you something. The word of God, she heard about Jesus. This woman was a woman that has money. This woman was a woman that believed on pastor, that believed on different type of prophet, different type of native daughter. When the money was there, she was running about different places. But when the money got finished, when friends ran away, family rejected her, the same gospel came to her. She received the gospel. She believed the gospel. And the gospel stirred her, faith. Stir up that faith. And the Bible says, when the faith stirred up and she believed that as I have received the word of God, I have that faith that even when Jesus is passing by, when I touch, something will transfer. Something must transform in my life, which is faith. When you look at it, Jesus Christ said, woman, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee Your feet has made thee whole. Malekozinde brogozi kalabrandaya. He said that faith has made thee whole, which is to say, every miracle that must be activated in your life need faith to work. Need faith. Any miracle that must come to pass, any miracle that must be manifested, any miracle that must take place must go with faith. If this woman has not even asked that faith, even when Jesus Christ lay his hand on him, lay his hand on her, nothing will ever change. Put your faith to work. Malega zandozi de brogozia, elege de brandozi kada brada bakanza daya. Let me tell you something. It is not time for us to wake up from our slumber. How long can we continue to depend on prophet? How long can we continue to depend on man? How long can we continue to depend on those native daughters? It is not time for us to stand up on our feet and say, when I pray, heaven will open. I believe that I have that faith that everything is turning around for good. Let me tell you something. The situation you are now is not your final bus stop. Where you are is not your final bus stop. Many people are getting married, you are not getting married. Put your faith to work and begin to declare in your life by faith that this month is my month. I will get a job. I speak into my January. I speak into my February. I will get married. Put your faith to work. Malekozinde brogozia. Put your faith to work. It is not time for us to say enough is enough. How long can we continue to dwell in and receive this insult? It is enough. A lot of us, after we still pray, when we wake, after we pray, immediately we finish praying, just a few moments after our prayer, we'll begin to doubt. That doubting spirit will be there. We'll begin to doubt. God, I don't think if this prayer I pray, I don't think if it will work. When will God answer me? Unbelief. Let me tell you something. The Bible says in the book of James chapter 1 or chapter 2, the Bible made us to understand that it said a doubting man is just like the wave of the sea. When you are doubting, you are just like the wave of the sea. You are not stable. God does not work with people that doubt his kind of personality. Hallelujah. God does not work with people that doubt. The Bible says, when you study your Bible carefully, the Bible says, after the 12 men has gone to the land of Canaan to spy that and see the people, if they can defeat them or not, Joshua and Caleb came to Moses and said, those people are like grasshopper before us. We will crush them and possess that land full of milk and honey. But the Bible says the other 10 gave a negative report and said, we were like grasshopper in their sight. We cannot crush them. And God got angry. And God made those people and the people that brought the report and those that believed in the report to crush, they crashed down like a grasshopper for their enemy, because that was what they declare and they believe. Every declaration you make to yourself, to your life, any declaration you made with your mouth and you believe it will come to pass. Be careful. Declare positively into your family. Declare positively into your marriage. It does not matter where you are today. What matter that you are coming out? Put your faith to work. Malaga zude brogozia. Put your faith to work. Numbers 23 verse 19. God is not a man that should lie, neither a son of man that will repent from his word. As God said a thing, he has not done it. As God spoken a thing that he has not come to pass. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is the God that answered by fire. The same God that consumed with fire. He is the God that delivered from fire. The same God that delivered from the lion's den. He is the God that walked upon the sea. The God that turned water to wine. It does not matter where you are today. God is bringing you out from that situation. Your story is turning around. I see God transforming you in the name of Jesus. Beloved brethren, until we begin to put our faith to work, nothing is going to change. Hallelujah. Kada Bragozini Manakaza da Bayekozia. I want us to also continue. I want us to pay attention to this, because we are going to be rounding up very, very soon. I want us to pay attention to this word. In life, whatsoever you believe and declare will come to pass. Let me tell you something, especially the ladies, I want you to understand this. Even though your husband does not have that belief, your husband is saying work is bad, I don't think, begin to declare. Tell him that I decree to that, I believe that when you go out tomorrow, there is a positive turn around. You decree into his life. Let me tell you something. That man in your father's compound, that woman in your mother's house that has declared upon your life and said you are not going to come out and achieve anything, you have to declare and tell them you are not my God. When God say yes, no man can say no. When God has not ordained a thing, it cannot come to pass. That is faith. On which belief do you depend on? Is it the report of men or the report of God? The doctor can tell you that, even the doctor can still tell you that you cannot have a child in your life. You open your mouth and tell the doctor, I serve a living God. In the kingdom of my father, in the city of Zion, my heavenly kingdom, the kingdom of my glorious God, there is no barrenness in that city. I came from a royal home whereby barrenness does not exist. It is not my turn. It is not my time. It is not for me to be barren. I refuse it and I reject it. It is not for me. The faith that works. Even when others are telling you, look at your life. You have traveled to Europe. You have traveled to Japan. You are still in Nigeria. Nothing is going to work out for you. You are going to remain there. You tell them, God is a God that when he said a thing, he comes to pass. Who is in that said a thing that God has not ordained? You put your faith to work. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Until, if you must climb to another level, if you must climb to another level, if you must upgrade, if you must graduate from this your current situation to that place of comfort, what you need to do is for you to rise up from your feet. It's not for you to rise up from your feet and say, it is over. I am climbing to that next level. God is turning my life around. The only thing we love to hear is just for a pastor. Let me tell you, even though when your pastor make a decree upon your life that you will prosper, when your faith is not at work, it will not come to pass. Believe me, whether you believe it or not, that is just the truth. Many of us just believe, once my papa, professor, daddy, professor. When the pastor still professor and your faith is not at work, it will not manifest. The Bible says, believe ye in the word, and ye shall be established. Believe in the prophet, and ye shall prosper. 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Let me tell you something. It's one thing for you to receive the prophecies. Another thing for you to believe. Every prophetic declaration upon your life that you do not believe will not work until you believe. As a believer, even when the storm arises, you still have that faith that I am not going to be overwhelmed with this thing. You believe. Put your faith to work. Put your faith to work. This is what you need to understand, beloved brethren. Even when the landlord is telling you, I'm going to throw you out from this house, put your faith to work and know that God is the God of the world. God is the God that can do a miracle in the last seconds. God is the God that can do a miracle in the last minute. The landlord will not throw me out, because I know God is the God, is the resurrection and life. There with him all things are possible, but with men everything is impossible. You decree and you say, yes, I know this strength is what declare. Now, beloved brethren, I want you to do this. For you to understand there is power in your tongue, that you can be able to rebuild what the devil have destroyed, that you can decree upon your life it will come to pass. What you have to do when you wake up every morning from bed, before you put anything in your mouth in the morning, make a decree upon your life, make a decree upon your family, speak life, declare things, let them begin to manifest. Hallelujah. Let them begin to manifest. In this year 2021, I refuse to remain in the same level I am now. I must climb to another level. You that sister, you that brother, that the devil has compassed your life around with different challenges, arise to your feet by faith and tell the devil, you are a bastard. You can't stop me, because my father, my brother, my elder brother, Jesus Christ, my father, my savior, has bruised your head. Now he has given me the power, the key of that is unto the life and death. He has given me dominion over you. Put your faith to work. Beloved brethren, to conclude is this. In life and destiny, always put and believe in God. It is one thing to pray. It's an undoubted thing for you to believe. Never look down on your own prayer. Never neglect your own prayer. If you still believe that if I pray for you, if you still have that faith in you, that if I pray for you, that yes, it will manifest in your life, also have that same belief that whenever you pray, God will always answer you. Don't look down on your prayers. Do not be deceived. There is nowhere in the Bible God has written that any pastor that believes in me and pray for anybody, any holy pastor can pray for anybody, it will be manifested. When the people that pray, if other people pray, I will not hear. If holy pastor, no. The Bible says, as many that believe in my name, I have given them power to become the sons of God. You are the son of God. You are already the light of the world. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 14, I am a light, a city that is set on a hill that cannot be hidden. You are a light of your family. You are the light of your generation. The devil cannot stop you. You will shine. You will shine. No power can limit you in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. It is now time for us to come to the conclusion of today's program. I want us to open our mouth and begin to worship the name of God. Open your mouth and adore Him. Worship the name of God. Worship the name of God. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Call Him sweet names. Call Him sweet names. Call Him sweet name. Call Him sweet name. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship God. You are the balm of Gilead. You are the rose of Sharon. You are my open door, midst of the storm. You are the air I breathe. Oh Lord, you are the air I breathe. Oh Lord, you are the balm of Gilead. You are the rose of Sharon. You are my peace in the midst of the storm. You are the air I breathe. Oh Lord, 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 you are. Father, I thank you for what you have done tonight. Thank you for staying up on our feet. Father, I decree upon the life of your children, anyone that has their faith has been to zero, anyone the devil has temper their life, that they are not worried. I decree and I declare by the power in the blood of Jesus, they are set free in the name of Jesus. I don't know you, that sister. I don't know you, that brother. I can see somebody here that the Spirit of God is ministering to my heart, that there is a particular challenge in your life that you don't know how it started. You have been there for many years. You have been declaring for many years. You don't know what to do. You are confused. But tonight, God has sent me to speak to that your mountain. I decree and I declare and I command that mountain to move in the name of Jesus. I command that mountain to move in the name of Jesus. I command that mountain to move in the name of Jesus. I speak to that mountain in your family. I speak to that mountain in your household, in your marriage, in your life. Today they are going out in the name of Jesus. Today they are going out in the name of Jesus. I decree that they are going out. I declare that they are going out in the name of Jesus. Father, be thou exalted. Be thou magnified. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Don't forget, next week, Wednesday, we are still going to be meeting in this platform by 9 p.m. on Wednesday. Never forget, same time, I remember your same servant of God. I remember Minister Promise Roberto. See you same time next week, Wednesday, by 9 p.m. God bless you. Shalom.